Look at that.
That looks awesome, huh?
It's a perfect little pinwheel.
Man, that flank is the best I've ever had.
You're the master. Oh, seriously.
No. You take a look at that, and there is no waste. 100% utilization of the animal. And it's as organic as you can get. Mm.
So this program today is going to be different than most of our hunting programs. And the reason why is because we're going to help you get more out of your meat. I think one thing that we have failed to do a good job on is show how to properly take care of animals. And what I'm talking about, how to properly field dress and butcher and cook animals. And so this program here is going to be geared towards that.
Look at that deer shoulder.
That's beautiful.
I'm Charles Allen with DiamondBlade Knives and Knives of Alaska. We're here on our ranch in East Texas. We're having Keith and Matti Warren in along with Tom Claycomb, who's a professional butcher, outdoor rider, and he's gonna show us how to properly prepare a individual cut from a wild boar, from a 8-point buck we took here, and one of the steers that we've taken off of our ranch.
My name's Tom Claycomb III. I'm an outdoor rider. Write for a lot of different publications, do a lot of outdoor seminars. After college, I went to Texas A&M, animal science degree, started working for the big packers. I've worked for three of the top four packers as a butcher. And so I took what I learned in the beef packing business and applied it in the outdoor world. Okay, we're going to show you how to take the lowly foreshoulder, the flank steak, and we're going to prepare it and show you. And if you don't want one right now just looking at it, then you flatline.
This is great. I can't wait to try the beef and the other cuts because I'm very impressed so far, I have to say.
Well, good. I'm glad.
All right, so you get your deer on the ground, and what do you do with him? Howdy, everybody. I'm Keith Warren. I'm with Charles Allen. Charles is with Knives of Alaska and DiamondBlade Knives. So you've got to take care of your animal properly, and we've got a white-tailed buck here. And hanging, and Charles is fixing to start skinning him right now. You'll notice on these long incisions what Charles has done, he's made cuts from the inside out. The reason for that is to minimize the amount of hair that's being cut as you cut through the skin.
And you also have silt and sand on hair. That's why the friction forged edge on these DiamondBlade knives will stay sharper than other knives. They're harder and yet they're not brittle. And that's really the holy grail for a knife maker.
All right, so Charles has just changed knives. Show them the blade of that knife. Hold on, take a look at that. Okay, it's a completely different shape blade. That's a different tool for doing this job, and tell them why you changed.
Well, the initial knife was a very sharp pointed, almost like a scalpel, and it's excellent for making your initial incision and for caping. This knife is made to skin. It has a long skinning radius and rolls that hair off. Whereas if you had more of a pointed knife, it can dig in and you just can't get as much work done with it. So this is the knife to use for skinning.
Yep. So we're gonna go ahead and get the skin off now. All right, so pay close attention to this because I almost guarantee you if you're a deer hunter, you don't save this piece of meat. And according to what Tom says, you're throwing away what could be the best cut of meat on the whole animal. Take a look at this. This is the hindquarters right here, and this is what they call the flank up in here, between the ribs and the front of the hindquarter. And Tom, show them on the steer.
Okay.
What it is.
Exact same thing on a cow, it's a lot bigger. So what you can do is look in there, and I'm gonna go slow, but you can see there's a definite line, a white line separating the flank and the flat meat. So what I'm gonna do, it just cut right down that line, all the way down, and that's the flank.
Okay, and that's a flank off a cow. Now, Tom, let me see that, and show them the flank off the deer. Okay. Cut it off the deer and show them. Now, this is probably the best cut of meat there is on the animal.
Guarantee you. To play it safe, I'm gonna go up a little high, yes sir, rib, even though I could be down a little. You can see here's the flank steak. Noticeably smaller than the cow, of course. So what I'm gonna do is go down here and it ties in right there, like Keith was saying earlier on that round. I'm gonna cut that out of there. There it is.
That right there is a flank steak off a white-tailed deer. Yep.
I
Okay, everybody, today we are gonna be cooking some wild game and some Wagyu. So go ahead and tell us what we got laying in front of us, what these beautiful pieces of meat are.
Okay, this is a really unique cut, and I guarantee you, you're gonna shoot your deer just for that plate.
Okay.
So we just have the Wagyu and the deer.
Okay, perfect.
So what we're gonna do, you're gonna chop up the onion, green pepper. We're going to get the seasoning, and I'm going to just season it. And we'll season it pretty heavy. I like the coarse seasoning. It just gives it a good flavor. It's good seasoning.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to put the green peppers and the onions in here.
Okay.
We're going to roll it up and pin it together with a toothpick.
Okay. So a little about the knife I'm using. We always use DiamondBlade knives in the field, whether we're caping out an animal, or we're skinning it, or just butchering. But now we can also use them in the kitchen. This is the 12-inch chef's knife, and we've used it all weekend cooking. It's held an edge great, and a lot of times, like, I have a really good knife set in my kitchen at home. It's one of those name brands, top of the line. They're expensive, but I have to sharpen it every single time I use it. And this DiamondBlade, you don't have to worry about that. So I'm really excited to have this. That way I can have all of my knives, whether they're for the field or for the kitchen. I know they're gonna hold an edge for a long time, so it's been great so far.
Usually I'll marinate these for a little bit, but I think what we're gonna do this time, I'm gonna just sprinkle marinade in there, pinwheel it, and it'll soak in here while we're preparing things, okay?
That sounds great to me.
Okay, I will pin it, roll it. If you want to help me pin it, it might ease up the situation quite a bit.
For sure.
We'll go and stick some toothpicks, stick one in there.
Perfect.
Here. So we'll throw it on, and I like to smoke it, like say, at least an hour, maybe two. And then since it's rolled up, it'll heat. When we turn it up to finish the cooking, you got to watch because
it'll heat up quick.
Cook in front of your eyes almost.
Okay.
And so there we are.
Man, look at that.
That looks awesome, huh?
It's a perfect little pinwheel. And then this is the venison pinwheel. It's little, but it's a perfect hors d'oeuvre for like a date night or something. Just two people or a couple people slice it up and it's gonna taste real good.
Oh, it'll be awesome.
Well, let's get it over the smoker.
Okay, man.
All right, so now we've got our little pinwheels. And they're gonna hit the smoker. How long are they gonna go on here for?
We'll smoke them 45 minutes to an hour, enough just to give them a good smoke flavor. And then we'll crank up the heat, which won't take long to finish them.
Okay, perfect. Well, let's get them on there.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay.
Might take a little nap while this is smoking. Awesome.
Perfect.
Well, now we'll go get them on the grill.
We'll carry them over for you then.
This is a flank steak, and you can see right here, we went over it whenever we originally set it up and seasoned it. It's got really, what would you call it, grainy meat? Like you can see the grain very easily in it.
Yeah, almost stringy. I mean, it's almost like the fibers are actual strings. It's so thick.
Yeah, so we're cutting against the grain here, and we stuffed it with some onions and bell peppers, seasoned it real good. It sat on the smoker for a while. And it's just gonna be a great little appetizer for us. So we gotta get to taste testing. Here, if I can get it on the fork.
Ready. Oh yeah.
The smoke is so good.
Isn't it? That's perfect, good smoking.
All right, you got the front shoulder of a white-tailed deer. Most people would think there's not much meat when it comes to the yield off the front shoulder, but Tom is fixing to show you something that's gonna blow your mind.
You won't believe me till you try it. When you bone this out, you're lucky to get what? One little handful of sausage, half sinew. The way we're going to show you to do this, you would eat every ounce, all the collagen dissolves, and we'll show you that in a bit. This is super simple to take off. We're going to use the new Knives of Alaska professional boning knife, the flexible model. The reason we want it this flexible, it gets what we call a cleaner bone, which means you're getting more meat off the bone. You're gonna hit the main seam in here. So I'm gonna go along, I'm gonna hit this brisket, take it with it, cut it, and I'm gonna backhand right through there. You can cut straight, and we're gonna follow this seam. And you're gonna hit the end of that, what we call the paddle bone, which is a scapula. We're gonna go right up, pretty much to the back here, and cut right down there, hitting that seam, and it's gonna just fall right off. It's that simple.
And so look at that. A lot of people, if you wind up cutting that back strap out first, you've got this little layer of meat and you've wasted it. And so cut your shoulders off first. All right, so now Tom's gonna do the exact same thing on this hog. Take the shoulder off. Go ahead.
So once again, it's a little bit different for you, but you're gonna hit that seam, pick up most of that brisket, pop it, come right through here, going up. We'll backhand right in there, and you see there's a seam, and just follow it. If you're hitting in a muscle, back up a little. So it's that simple. You'll follow that paddle bone back, get right back in there, hit along that backbone. You're going to just drop it right off. You don't want to hit into the back strap, really. And you're going to cut. There it is.
And again, you want to wind up taking the shoulders off before the back strap. All right, Tom, get after it. Tell them what you're doing.
Okay, this is very simple. We're going to cut off the shanks on all these. But what we're going to do, we're going to cut around there. And like I say, it can be tricky unless you've done quite a few. This spool joint will be a little tricky for you. If you get totally frustrated, just cheat. Get a sawzall, a hacksaw, cut it off. And you'll see it looks almost like a spool of thread, like your wife's sewing. Mm-hmm. You're going to, oh, that's why they call it a spool joint. And there we are right there. And you've got to go around. Now you don't want to cram because that bone's hard and you'll dull your knife fast. So see how I'm hitting those tendons? I get right in there and there's that spool joint. You can see how it's round.
Yep, see that joint right there? Yeah, that joint you can actually see where it was connected here. Okay, go ahead and get the shank off these other ones and okay. We'll get busy.
Sounds good, man. Okay, here's what I'm excited about. This is your forequarter, or foreshoulder.
Mm-hmm.
If you bone this out, it's just all tendons and ligaments, right?
Right.
So normally what you do, you bone it for hamburger or sausage, you get a handful of meat.
Mm-hmm.
You will not believe it. We're going to try it. And from now on, you'll shoot deer just for this foreshoulder.
Okay.
We're going to just season it. And when we get done, you will literally eat everything but the bone.
Okay. Well, you show, and this is venison. And then what are we going to do with the pork? Same thing?
So it's pretty much the same routine on any of your wild game.
Okay. Well, let's have at it,
I guess.
I'm ready.
All we're going to do, I like a coarse seasoning. It's a little wet, I've washed it off, so we'll just kind of pat it in there. Nothing magical.
It smells good already.
Doesn't it?
Well, I can't wait. Let's go to the smoker.
Okay, you ready to carry them over?
I am. This will be a team effort. It's a lot of meat.
It'll be good if we don't drop them.
Okay.
For the show, I guess. Huh?
All right, we're going to place these on the smoker now. Just right here.
You bet. That's perfect.
Okay. All right. Perfect. We'll see these in a couple hours.
See you in a bit. All right.
All right. Let's see what this turned out like.
You ready?
Oh, I'm ready.
Okay.
Oh my gosh, it smells amazing.
Doesn't it? Look at that deer shoulder.
That's beautiful.
You ready?
I'm ready. We're gonna put it in here and put a couple cups of water on it. And then we're gonna put it in the oven at what?
205, 210.
Okay, real low and slow. We're gonna leave the pork on the smoker to get a nice crisp, but it looks like it's doing pretty good so far.
It is, isn't it?
Oh yeah. Good. I can't wait for supper time. Okay, so yesterday we put these shoulders on the smoker and they were on the smoker for a while. Then we put the venison in the oven in this Dutch oven. And a little while later we put the pork in there just to make sure it didn't dry out. That was like 12 hours ago. So we're gonna open these up and see what they look like, slap them on here and see how they turned out.
It's gonna fall apart.
Oh my goodness. You weren't kidding when you said it'll just fall right off the bone.
It's tender, huh?
Very tender.
You want the pork on here?
Yeah, you put the pork on here. Oh, look at that beautiful crust on the pork.
Isn't it?
This, folks, is some delicious venison shoulder. Seriously, this is amazing. And how do you usually fix this meat up?
I'll get a knife like this DiamondBlade chef knife. I'm going to chop it. You don't have to get real weird. Just do it about a quarter, half inch.
Well, these look delicious. This is the venison, and then this is the pork, which we left on the smoker a little bit longer. Let's just cut off a piece and show everybody what the inside looks like. Look at that. Moist, perfect, falling apart. This is like a pulled pork, essentially. If you want to cook it with some broth or like a can of beer, it'd be good. But this just goes to show you that don't throw away your shoulders or grind them up. You can get real creative with them. And this meat, we'll probably put it in some baggies and meal prep. You can make soups with it. Like you said, sandwiches, little taco bowls, carne asada. This is top notch, so thank you. Seriously, this has been a blast. We gotta go get to eating and make some sandwiches.
Cut that film, we gotta eat.
Thanks for watching part two of this Wild Game Meat series. If you learned something, be sure to be on the lookout for other cooking episodes to help you get more out of your meat. And head on over to our YouTube channel, where we're posting tons of action-packed hunting and outdoor content. Thanks for watching The High Road. We'll see you next time.
Okay, here are the venison, I want to call it pulled pork because it looks like pulled pork, but the venison shoulder sandwiches. Everybody get a piece. Here, you want one?
You bet.
Here you go, Charles.
You bet.
Jody.
I can't believe that's venison.
I know, look at it, it's beautiful.
Falling off.
Tom.
Unbelievable. Thank you, ma'am.
You're the mastermind behind all of this. Now, this has been a blast. I thank y'all for opening up your home and for letting us test some great knives and learn more about animals.
Great having you.
Yeah.
Our pleasure, we've really enjoyed it.
Well, cheers.
Enjoyed your company.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Tell y'all something. You take a look at that. And there is no waste. 100% utilization of the animal. And it's as organic as you can get. Good job, everybody. Thanks.
You bet.
And thank y'all for watching.